It's Javi and
here with Naro and the returning superstar. Not really. Ari. Ari's back with us, guys.
Welcome back.
Looking all burnt.
Hi.
Not really, because I fixed that.
Hi.
She did.
So
time for Quick Fix, guys, which is a weekly rundown of the news that we missed in the week. So, and already?
Ready? Get started? Ready.
All right. So, first topic. Aishana has been blasted by fans throughout the week for an IG post which said, "Mina dressed in a tablecloth like Miss Lou, hashtag RIP Miss Lou." The post was seen by many as disrespectful to the late Jamaican poet Louise Simone Bennett Coverley. Those who have criticized her for the post include Raga Shanti, who said she crossed the line, Culture Minister Olivia Babsy-Grange, who called her very disrespectful and called for an apology, while Faye Ellington also call Aishana's action shameful. So what do we think about the criticism levied at Aishana for her posts?
Well, as we said, well, you guys said earlier in the week, I wasn't here, I called in. But as I said, like, she really didn't know that, or she never meant for it to be disrespectful. That was it. Her intention wasn't meant to be. Her intention wasn't meant to be disrespectful. I mean, the furrow and all the uproar that's being levied at her. I mean, to me, I think it's just too much. Yeah. You know, it really is unnecessary. I agree that she should apologize, now she knows, she should apologize, because it really is a national symbol and a costume for us. And she should apologize for that. But I mean, as I said, it really wasn't meant to be taken as a disrespect. It wasn't intentionally disrespectful, but I guess whether it was intentional or not, it was seen as disrespect, and so she should apologize for that. But as I said, I don't think it was meant
ladies
to be disrespectful.
Ladies and gents, Aishana, we are talking about is the same lady who gives a new meaning to Pepsi and bag juice. Men will never look at those items the same again because of this woman. She did, it would be edgy, it's a little slight thing what she do.
Yeah.
As I kind of agree with you about the fervor and thing around it. It's like, come on, we look into Aishana for good statesmanship and them type of thing. Aishana.
Is that really? Una didn't expect
like, I guess an apology is owed.
As
I said, it never intended, but it's still disrespectful nonetheless. Right. So, you know, quick apology and
get over it.
Tanya Stevens will come out in defense of her. She's saying that, you know, like, you know, I guess it's the same thing as you said, like, it's too much and it's extraness in short. Yeah. You're like Aishana.
Yeah, it's like Aishana is like criticizing a porn star for saying something stupid while doing porn.
And on that note,
next topic.
I'm just saying, it's not to say Aishana is a porn star. I'm just saying, you know.
You're making an analogy.
Yes, it is an analogy.
Yeah. A bad one at that, but okay.
You whatever. Hear a little whistling in the studio. All right, so the next topic. The Shaggy Make a Difference Foundation, SMADF, on Wednesday handed over much needed medical equipment to the Bustamante Hospital for Children. It is the first of a two-part handover of equipment, furniture, parts, and accessories with a combined value of more than $529,000.
Nice.
Good move, right?
Yeah, very good move.
Big up Shaggy always. Shaggy always doing them type of, you know, philanthropic efforts in the country. Yeah. One of them artists that we can always count upon to do them type of thing. Yeah. Personally speaking, my mother is a nurse, so me know all the hospital them run down and in need of much needed stuff. Like, the hospital they go in and them don't look good. They don't have the things that they need to be a properly run hospital. So the fact that somebody like Shaggy see them need and address it, you know, it's a good look.
Last week I said I don't remember if any active dancer artists, because we talk about Idonia own, but then I don't know. I guess I slipped that Shaggy's a dancehall artist. Yep. I forget. I'm sorry, but you know,
no, the crossover and something will get lost.
Yeah. Like, I don't know,
in
but
the fact that he's a
dancehall artist. So again, we like to highlight things like this because, you know, they always be put on. They're always put on the back burner.
Yeah.
So he's always been doing this. He's been doing his Make a Difference concert. concert, Let's Make a Difference, Dare to Care, is always a good look and great for the children.
Because it's
for
the children's hospital. Right.
It's like
right.
Each other the early funds, in the year, right?
Yeah.
January,
funds
yeah.
go towards like hospitals. Towards
yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. And it's same a great concert yep, that yep. they put on. They always get some really good acts to come and
perform.
Draw the money out of the people them. So again, yeah. a very good look. Good, Shaggy. Good.
Yeah. All right. So our next topic, Magnum, King of the Dancehall winner Devin the Doctor, has become the first winner from the competition to earn an entry on the US Billboard charts. His collaboration, O Devil, with California-based Electric Guest, debuts at number 47 on the Hot Rock Songs chart. So how do we feel about this, guys? Is it good?
I listened to the song. Right. I listened to the song. It. I was like, hot rock. What is hot rock? But I'm assuming it's still rock. It's a nice little song. Like I don't remember it now, but I was listening to it while.
That's what they call it, hot rock.
Yes, that's the chart. It's on Billboard Hot Rock, whatever that is.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So I like the song though. At first I was confused as to who, where, what, how Devin fall into place, because apparently he was doing the chorus.
Yeah.
So when the chorus come on, I was like, oh, you hear it, but then kind of heavily change up in voice a bit, so you never really recognize that it's Devin the Doctor. But the song is a good song, so yeah, I'm glad.
Now you sing the same.
As long as the man get him featured credits,
yeah, Devin the
Doctor.
Alright,
I'm not gonna throw no shade this week. Alright, plop plop plop. Yeah, as long as the man get a featured credits, it's a good look. Yep. Devin just doing the damn thing. He's doing it. And him doing
Grammy
it well.
Grammy nominated last you know what I mean? Year or this year.
Him setting a, this year.
And to now be featured on the, and it's not even for dancehall. Mm-hmm. It's a completely different.
Yep.
It's not hip hop.
Yep.
It's not pop. It's hot rock.
Hot rock.
So
songs.
I mean, this is an incredible
rock songs, but them just call it
hot rock because it kind of have a, like a pop feel to it. Yeah. So I guess that's why. So I mean, it's really good for you, Devin. Good for you.
Come on, expand the territory.
Go. You're not fighting for dancehall. You're not fighting to be the king of dancehall. You're trying to go
just
over and get into
overall.
That.
Getting it in a different way. I mean, like
the strategy is good too.
Yo, Shelly and Karen, bigger person.
Yeah,
bigger person. You're sexy to us.
All right. So, the final topic. French Montana dropped his highly anticipated album today, which I'm sure Naro will illegally download. And one track that has caught the attention of dancehall fans is his collaboration with Alkaline titled Formula. So we have the clip, Blins.
Round like a foreigner, gon' stay a warrior. Same boss by the show, you know. One show, what you get for a tour, you know. You on my face on the wall, you know.
Formula.
Montana. Alright, so, oh yeah, sorry. So guys, what do you think about the song?
Actually, I was expecting, so I don't know why I keep on expecting something different when I hear refix and reworking of songs now, but yeah. I am so glad that Lee Miller is an actual Lee Miller production. It never seemed in any way, shape or form, tech out, mix up, niggle up. It's like the actual Formula song. And French Montana decided that he wanted to put his own twist on the original version of the song. And him create Alkaline. And Alkaline is very much present on the track. And you can even see that French Montana was trying to work with Alkaline, with his vibe, with his style.
Foreigner.
Yeah, you know. So I try to do like a part or something too. So, yeah. But I
didn't hear it. I didn't hear him trying to do any part. And to add to
what... A little bit
is, you know, as long as they not got too out of pocket and I try sound like with too much and then them sound completely different, you know what I mean? But him add a little bit, it's not too much. And for add to what I say, like, yo, I love the song. Mm. We love the song. We like say it's
see,
still.
See, we're not Alkaline haters.
Yeah, you are giving the prop.
You people, we are like, not Alkaline haters.
I like
haters.
The energy of the song. Yeah. It never take it and hip-hopatize
it.
You know what I mean? It could have easily do that and chop music it up and give a little, but keep the same energy of the song. As I say, Alkaline presence still on it.
Yeah. Lee
like
Miller production
still
on the
it. Song.
Yeah.
Like, me like the song. I can't say nothing else, but other than me like it. Vince, you have something to say?
Wagwan, Jamaica.
That's Vince the engineer, man.
French ain't say that.
Yeah, like, it's a good look for Alkaline because, yeah, as we said, them could have easily take the song. Because when you see this, it's not like Conscience and say like a Chris Brown. Mm-hmm. It's not like that. It's a hip hop artist take a dancehall song and expect some sort of difference, but yeah, it's the same song.
It's not like, you know, Drake and
yeah,
why you gotta bring him into this?
No,
that's
a good point, because Drake would have taken it. Drake would have taken it and slow it down and do him Drake-ism and just use some little snippets of your voice, and then that's what Drake does.
Gala, it's the same.
Yeah, that's all the ear.
You fly out regular.
Right? And then when him done Drake-atize it, the song is unrecognizable, yeah, but it's still from me. Like it. Yes. I like this.
You
really
go,
do.
Alkaline.
And French Montana, like, kudos to you, sir. Yeah. For really respecting, yeah, mm-hmm, respecting the genre, respecting, yeah, the work.
Mm-hmm.
And as I said, thank God you never
hip-hop-ize
it. You really and truly kept the dancehall flavor to it. Mm-hmm. So, but even his song Unforgettable, it kind of have a dancehall feel to, yeah, it too. Yeah, you know? Dancehall Afrobeat to it. Yeah.
All right, so can we get off of Alkaline's proverbial D, right?
Fine. So that's it.
No, we have some people always say that we're Alkaline haters. So, you know,
give him props when it's due. So, yeah, get the props right.
And 2016 was really his year. He proved to us that it really was 2016. Mm-hmm. So good for you, Alkaline.
Big up
good
French, big up Alkaline.
Yeah. All right, so we're done.
Quick fix.